Lecture will discuss about CSMA/CD. CSMA/CD stands for Carrier Sense Multiple Access with Collision Detection. So in the previous lecture, what we have seen about CSMA method, it does not specify the procedure following a collision. To augment a particular algorithm that will handle this collision is the carrier sense multiple access with collision detection. So CSMA/CD augments the algorithm to handle the collision. So in this method, CSMA/CD, a station monitors the medium after it sends a frame to see if the transmission was successful. If the transmission was successful, the station is finished. But if, however, there is a collision, the frame is sent again. Okay, so whatever is this CSMA/CD, to better understand this, we'll have a look at the first bits transmitted by the two stations involved in the collision. Although each station continues to send bits in the frame until it detects the collision, then here we are going to show what happens as the first bits collide. So there is a particular figure that will show this, what happens as the first bit collides, where stations A and C are involved in the collision. So this diagram represents where station A and C are involved in the collision. Okay, so you can see A is at leftmost part, D is at rightmost part. At time T1, you can see here, first bit of A is at time T1. At time T1, station A has executed its persistent procedure and it will start sending the bit of its frame. Then at time T2, you can see station C, here you can see at time T2, station C has not yet sent the first bit sent by A. Station C executes its persistence procedure and starts sending the bits in its frame, which propagate both to the left and to the right. Right, the collision occurs somewhere after time T2. So you can see collision occurs somewhere after time T2. Okay, this is time T2. After T2, somewhere it occurs a collision. Here is the collision. Okay, because bits will be propagating in both right and left. Okay. Station C detects a collision at time T3. You can see this is time T3. At time T3, station C detects a collision when it receives the first bit of A's frame. Here is coming the first bit of A's frame. Station C immediately, or it may be after a short time, but it is assumed that it is immediate, aborts transmission. So station C stops transmission. Station A detects a collision at time T4. You can see this is time T4. So station A detects a collision at time T4 when it receives the first bit of C's frame. Then it also immediately aborts transmission. So in this figure we are seeing that A transmits for the duration of T1 to T4. That is, T4 minus T1 is the duration for sending the bits from station A, and C transmits for the duration of T3 minus T2. T3 minus T2 is a duration for station C to send. Okay, now we'll see. So this is regarding this. Now there is a diagram showing collision and abortion in CSMA/CD. So we can see, we know the time durations for the two transmissions. Then we can have a complete graph. So the complete graph has been shown in collision and abortion in CSMA/CD. You can see A detects collision and aborts here. it detects collision abouts. Here collision occurs. Here C detects collision and abouts. Okay, so this is a, then this is the area that is showing part of A's frame, part of C's frame. Okay, next we'll see about minimum frame size. If the CSMA CD has to work, then there is a need to have a restriction on the frame size, on the frame size. So before sending the last bit of the frame, whatever is the sending station must detect a collision, and if there is any collision, then it must abort the transmission. Why this is so? Because the station, once the entire frame is sent, does not keep a copy of the frame and does not monitor the line for collision detection. Therefore, the frame transmission time TFR, here it has been shown, must be at least 2 times the maximum propagation time TP. Then we have to understand the reason. We have to think about worst case scenario. If the two stations involved in a collision are the maximum distance apart, the signal from the first takes time TP to reach the second, and the effect of the collision takes another time TP to reach the first. So what is the requirement is that first station must still be transmitting after 2 TP. Next we have a problem. We'll see that problem. So a network problem is, or example, a network transmits using CSMA/CD which has a bandwidth of 10 Mbps. If the maximum propagation time, including the delays in the devices and ignoring the time needed to send a jamming signal, is 25.6 microseconds, what is the minimum size of the frame? The solution is, the minimum frame transmission time is TFR, which is 2 into TP. So TP is given. How much it is? 25.6 microseconds. Substitute that. So 2 into 25.6 microseconds is 51.2 microseconds. What does this mean is that in the worst case, a station needs to transmit for a period of 51.2 microseconds to detect the collision. Then the minimum size of the frame is 10 Mbps into 51.2 microseconds, which is 512 bits or 64 bytes, which is the actually the minimum size of the standard Ethernet. Okay, then this is a flow diagram for CSMA/CD. You can see the diagram for CSMA/CD. So here the legend, TFR frame average transmission time, K number of attempts, R random number, 0 to 2 raised to K-1, TB back off period. Okay, so station has a frame to send, K equal to 0. So apply one of the persistent methods. Then if it is false, done or collision. If it is true, then collision detection. False, success. Then if it is true, send a jamming signal. K will get incremented by 1, K plus 1. Then if K is less than 15, false, abort. If it is true, less than 15, we have to continue. Create random number, then wait TB seconds, then continue. Okay, so you can see, apply one of the persistent method, then done or collision. If it is false, transmit and receive. So this is a flow diagram for CSM. So now we'll discuss about the differences between Aloha and CSMA/CD. The first difference is the addition of persistent process. Total there are 3 differences. The first difference is addition of the persistent process. What does this mean is that there is a need to sense the channel before we start sending the frame by using one of the persistent processes, which we have discussed earlier as non-persistent, one persistent, p-prat. Then whatever is a corresponding box, it can be replaced by one of the persistent process. Now we'll see the second difference. The second difference is a frame transmission. In Aloha, we first transmit the entire frame and we are going to wait for acknowledgement. But in CSMA/CD, the transmission and collision detection are continuous process. There is no need to send the entire frame and then look for a collision. So the station transmits and receives continuously and simultaneously. Then we are going to use a loop to show that transmission is a continuous process. Then there is need to constantly monitor in order to detect one of the condition. What are the two? One of the two condition is either transmission is finished or a collision is detected. Either event stops transmission. When it comes out of the loop, if a collision has not been detected, then the transmission is complete. So the entire frame is transmitted, otherwise a collision has occurred. The third difference is the sending of a short jamming signal to make sure that all other stations become aware of the collision. Next, energy levels. So we can see that the level of energy in a channel can have three values: 0, normal and abnormal. At the 0 level, the channel is idle, whereas at the normal level, a station has successfully captured the channel and is sending its frame. Whereas at the abnormal level, there is a collision and the level of the energy is twice the normal level. A station that has a frame to send or is sending a frame needs to monitor the energy level to determine if the channel is idle, busy or in collision mode. Okay. Next, throughput and traditional Ethernet. So throughput means the throughput of a CSMA/CD is greater than that of pure or slotted Aloha. The maximum throughput will occur for different values of G, which is based on the persistent method, and the value of P in P persistent approach. If it is a one persistent method, the maximum throughput is around 50% when G equal to 1. Whereas for non-persistent method, the maximum throughput can be up to 90% when G is between 3 and 8. Next, we'll go for traditional Ethernet. So whatever is the CSMA/CD, it was used by one of the LAN protocols, that is a traditional Ethernet, with the data rate of 10 Mbps. Okay, 10 Mbps. Then the traditional Ethernet was a broadcast LAN that used the one persistent method to control access to the common media. But whatever are the later versions of Ethernet, they try to move from CSMA/CDSS method for some of the reasons. So I'll complete here. We'll go through this. In next, I'll be seeing about CSMA/CA. Okay.